Good morning, my dear students, and welcome to Zenith Tutorials once again. Today we are doing the poem The Cold Within. Now this poem is from our textbook Treasure Trove for ICSE class 9th and 10th. So let's go ahead with the poem. The first stanza says, six humans trapped by happenstance in bleak and bitter cold, each one possessed a stick of wood, or so the story is told. Now, what is the meaning of happenstance? Happenstance means coincidence, by chance. Bleak and bitter means bad or the situation which is not encouraging or hopeful. So, here the author says that six human beings, that is six persons, are trapped by coincidence in bleak and bitter cold. So, they are trapped by a coincidence in very biting cold. And each one possesses a stick of wood. Each one of them is having a stick of wood, or so the story is told. So this forms the background of the poem around which the story is narrated. So in the first paragraph, the author wants to say that there are six humans that are trapped together by chance in biting cold, and each one of them has a stick of wood. And this forms the setting of the poem, and against this background, the story is narrated. Now let's look at our second stanza. The dying fire in need of logs, but the first one held hers back. For of the faces round the fire, she noticed one was black. So now from the first stanza, we know that it was biting cold outside. So their dying fire in need of logs. So the dying fire, the only fire that was keeping their bodies warm, was dying out. The only way to keep that fire alive was to put in use the logs that they were carrying, the sticks, wood sticks that they were carrying. So the dying fire in need of logs, their dying fire needed logs. But the first one held her back. So the first person that the poet is talking about in that group is a woman. Why it is a woman? How you can say that it is a woman? By this word, her. One holds her back. And what she holds back? She holds her wood, the stick of wood back. She doesn't want to put that stick of wood into use. For the why? Of the faces round the fire, she noticed one was black. So when she saw the people around the fire, she noticed that one person in that group was black. So this was the reason why she did not put her log into use, why she did not put her wood in the fire, because she saw a black person and she was prejudiced about the black person. So this stanza shows the attitude of a white person towards a black person. Now let's look at the third paragraph. The next man looking across the way saw one knot of his church and could not bring himself to give the fire his stick of birch. Here, the stick of birch. Birch is a type of a tree which has smooth thin branches. So stick of birch means the stick of that tree. Here the stick of birch means that stick of wood that he was carrying. So what does this mean? That the next man after the women, the next man looked across the way. He looked across the way and saw that one person was not of his church. Means of not of the same religious belief that he is. And this fact stops him from not using his stick of wood in the fire. So this shows the attitude of the second man against a person who does not belong to his church, his religious belief. Now let's look at the fourth paragraph. The third one sat in tattered clothes. He gave his coat a hitch. Why should his log be put to use to warm the idle rich? Now, this stanza talks about the attitude of a poor person towards a rich person. So the third one is sitting in tattered clothes. Tattered means worn out or torn clothes. So this shows that he is a poor person. The third one is a poor person. He gave his coat a hitch. He grabbed his coat and thought, why should his log be put to use? He's saying, why should I use my log, my wood, to warm the idle rich? That why should I use my stick to give warmth to the idle rich? The poet has used the word, the phrase idle rich, means the rich person who sits idly, means a rich person who doesn't do any work. So the third man is saying that he doesn't want to use his wood, his log to warm the idle rich. So this shows the attitude of a poor person towards a rich person. He doesn't want to use his log to give warmth to a rich person. The fifth paragraph reads, the rich man just sat back and thought of the wealth he had in store and how to keep what he had earned from the lazy, shiftless poor. In this stanza, the next man is a rich man. So the rich man just sat there and thought of the wealth he had in store. How much wealth he has with him. So he's thinking of that wealth and how to keep that wealth that he had earned from the lazy, shiftless poor. So here, the rich man is calling the poor as lazy and shiftless. Now, shiftless is a person that is characterized by laziness or lack of ambition. So the rich person, so here, this paragraph or this stanza talks about the attitude of a rich man towards a poor person. And he thinks that a poor person is a shiftless person, a lazy person. So how he should keep his wealth away from a lazy poor person. So this paragraph talks mainly about the attitude of a rich person towards a poor person, and that is why he doesn't want to put his log into use. And let's read the sixth paragraph. The black man's face bespoke revenge as the fire passed from his sight. All he saw in his stick of wood was a chance to spite the white. Now, this paragraph speaks about the attitude of a black person towards a white person. So, the black man's face bespoke revenge. Bespoke revenge means indicated revenge. We can see the revenge on his face. So, his face showed revenge as the fire passed from his sight. So, when fire passed from his sight, his face was revengeful. For all he saw in his stick of wood was a chance to spite the white. Because when he saw his stick, when he saw his wood, all that he can see in that wood was the chance to hurt the white. To spite the white means a desire to hurt. So, when he saw his wood, he could only see that this is my only chance. This is the only chance where I can hurt the white man. So, let's read the seventh stanza. The last man of this forlorn group did not accept for gain. Giving only to those who gave was how he played the game. So this paragraph talks about the last man of the group. Now here the poet is indicating the word forlorn for the group. He is using the word forlorn. Forlorn means lonely or sad. So this group is lonely because all of them have some different attitudes for each other. So this group is lonely. Everyone is lonely in the group. So that is why a forlorn group did not. Not means zero or nothing. So did not accept for gain. So here he is talking about the characteristic of the last man, that he is the type of a man who does nothing except for his benefit. Gain means benefit. So he does something only for his own benefit. He is of the type who gives only to those who give. He gives something to those who can give him something in return, was how he played the game. So this was his characteristic, that he did nothing except for gain. He does anything only for his benefit, and he gives only to those who give him something in return. So this is the characteristic of the last man. The eighth and the last paragraph reads, the logs held tight in death's still hands was proof of human sin. They did not die from cold without, they died from cold within. So their logs being held tight in the hands invited death. Since they held their logs tight in the hand and did not give their log in the fire, so this invited death for them. And this was a proof of human sin. Sin is any act which you do, which is against the law of any religion. Paap, that is sin. They did not die from cold without. So they did not die from the cold that was outside, the biting cold that was outside. They did not die because of that biting cold, but they died because of the cold within. Why is it said cold within? Because there was lack of warmth and compassion for human relationships in their hearts. So because of that lack of warmth or compassion for their fellow men, they died. So this poem is a pointed comment on the lack of warmth and compassion for our fellow humans. And the poem, through the discriminatory acts of these six people, tries to depict the attitude of human beings in general. If you have liked our explanation, please give us a thumbs up and share this video with your friends, and also do not forget to subscribe us. Thank you.